ladies and gentlemen. So this is what stage fright feels like, huh? This is awesome. Wow. Can we turn the lights on for a sec or not? No, I'm just kidding, I'm kidding, I'm kidding. People are sitting here in the front row going, oh my God, is he really going to do the dancing stuff? So basically, this is literally my first time here. And you can see that, look at that. I'm shaking. This is awesome because I never shake. I've always got, you know, something to say. There's always, I'm a teacher, I'm a dance teacher. You know, I'm there going, okay, ladies, you're going to do this with your hips. And smile, smile, please. Yeah, and here I'm like, wow, because you're expecting me to say something funny, yeah? Exactly, that's what you pay for. No, I'm just going to tell my mom about my family. If you've read the bottom part of it, my act is called What Just Happened. And that's how I feel, because I came here in 1980, and now I'm here. I'm 47. Came from Russia to Israel, lived in Israel for 5, 6 years, 10 years. Came here in 1980, now I'm here. And I've always wanted to do comedy. I've always wanted to show people what my family was like. And I said to my mom as we're leaving the house, and my partner, where's Anna? She's here somewhere. Where are you, Anna?
Filming.
Good. Good. Because I tried some of the stuff on her the other night, and she just sat there, she went, I went, you're not Jewish, you won't understand. She goes, no, they won't understand either. So I call her Black Hat now. I'm like, whenever I say something interesting, she goes, no, don't do that. Just don't. So I wanted to explain how I survived, yeah, coming here. And the reason I'm looking down here, sorry folks up there, is because the lights are so bright. I can see the faces here, and then they kind of, you know. And so up here, they're like this. And back there, my mother went for a walk down, I think it was Alma Road, and we were 2 weeks in Australia, and she saw a mug and dubbing, and she went, ah, my son will go here. Needless to say, she was sentencing me to Yeshiva College. Ballet dancer at Yeshiva College, pretty much hated by everybody. But my saving grace was my Uncle Moish. He was like, my whole family was like, you have to do this, you're a Russian man, you have to be Russian, you have to have a trade. My dad, you have to, знаешь, специальность, нужно тебе. Any Russians here? Yeah? Знаешь, нужно специальность, you need a trade, your man has to have a trade. I said, Dad, I'm going to dance with women and get paid for it. He goes, you stupid, go talk to your mother. Does more, please. Yeah. So, my mom said, Roy, you know, he's beautiful, he's going to be a dance teacher. Yeah, he's going to grow up to do that. And my Uncle Moish is like, he needs to come with me. And Moish, I have these ideas that Uncle Moish had. He had these wild fantasies about creating income in different ways. Like for example, he heard you can make money out of being a moyle. And so, you think I'm kidding? My uncle, most of the time I saw him drunk, but that's when he was at his best, right? I said, why are you going to be a moyle? Oh, you don't understand, you know, because a moyle, I'm going to collect all the offcuts. I said, you can't do, what are you going to do with me? I'm going to make wallets. And, no, but listen, I said, wallets, it's very good. You take the wallet, you want to go holiday, you rub it and it turns into a suitcase. I said, uncle, that's how I grew up, I swear to God. We'll drive with my dad down the street. Remember those days with no seatbelts and people would smoke in their cars? All those fun days, yeah? No security gates on building sites. There'd be a pile of bricks. We'd come back here tonight, we'd take the bricks. I said, Dad, somebody's building a house. You can't do that. That's it. No, why don't they leave it outside? I'm like 12, right? I know this. I know that you can't. And he's like, why the Pavlik, that's what I call my Russian is Pavlik. Pavlik, listen, the chicken teaches the egg. The egg doesn't teach the chicken. And you know what? This is the law in Australia. They leave it outside, it's for everybody. I couldn't argue, so here I am at 12 midnight, piling bricks into a trailer. And so So I grew up. Michael Moyes had this fascination with trying all sorts of different vodkas because I was a big drinker. And we walked, he said, my dad said, this, go with, I'm 15 now, right? So I'm a bit big. I had a, like this, I'm small. When I was 15, 17, I had a chest. Now I've got these two brown spots where it used to be. I'm now 47. But I was his protection. So, whoa, I did taekwondo. We walked into a bar together and said, stay here. I'm going to drink. And he walked up and there was a big jar of money on the bar. And I was watching him. And, you know, there's a big Russian bouncer, you know, Vova. Yeah, store. And he's like, what's... And the barman's looking at him, and I'm like, what's he going to do? What is this? The money. The barman says to him, this is a competition we have. And he's looking around at me, he's like, is he with you? I'm like, this is a competition we have. You have three tasks to perform, and if you do them well, you get the jar of money. And Michael Moyes is like, looking back at me, as if he knows what's going on. So, what is the first thing? The barman says, well, see Volvo over there. Volvo's 8 foot. You know, ex-KGB. Bouncer. You have to knock him out with one punch. And Moshe goes, right. Walks up to him, taps Volvo on the shoulder. Volvo, stop it, boy. Boom! Volvo's down. The bar stops. Everyone's looking at, oh, like, what the hell? He's like, the guy's out. He comes back up to the bar, the barman, no, what's next? He says, barman says, he's a bit nervous now. I was like, this guy, he said, well, out the back, we have a 75 kilogram Rottweiler who hasn't eaten for 3 days. He's got a sore tooth. You need to pull the tooth out. And, okay. And then, because I don't want to waste your time, what is after this? Well, okay, well, upstairs we have Betsy. She's a lady of the night. She's 98. You have to go and have your way with her.
Right, okay.
Moish, I'm watching, he walks, goes out the back, and everyone's listening, and I'm sitting there going, what is going on? And suddenly you hear, Moish come back into the bar. I'm like, I'm horrified. I'm like, walks in. Right. Where is the lady with the sore tooth? Do you understand? This is my life. You know, this is my life. That's what sort of stuff I had to deal with. You know, my mum. We're having an argument with my mum. I was 12, I thought I was smart, say something, she would say something back, I would say something, and she came out, you know, in Russia, your father and I were comedians. Right? And you were the first joke. And she made, you know that face when they make? I said, like, you're the first joke, there you go. Ladies and gentlemen, you've been absolutely wonderful. Thank you so much for helping me come on, Jerry. Wow. I hope to see you again. Thank you guys. Bye-bye for now.